Conveyancing is the process where ownership is transferred from one person to the other. In order for that process to start, we enter into an agreement of sale, and that's what gets sent to a conveyancer, who in terms of the Deeds Registry Act is the only person who can execute any deeds at the deeds office. So that's the first step. We get that OTP that's been accepted by the seller, and that's when our process starts. The first step is obtaining security documents from the bank. What are those security documents? Those are your original title deeds that are kept as security by the financial institutions, or if there's no bond in place, by the owner. We obtain these documents in order to determine what the conditions of title are, and we will need them to lodge at the deeds office with our new draft deed. So that's our first step. This is also the step that we request cancellation figures from the banks. What are cancellation figures? Those are the existing bond you have over your property that needs to be cancelled in order for this matter to be transferred at the deeds office. It's then that we quickly go to the municipalities and we obtain figures, because we all know that as part of our pack, we need to ensure that there's a rates clearance certificate in place. We do this as quickly as possible because there is a process involved at the rates department, and it can take up to a month to obtain these figures. The next step would be to ensure that the purchase price is secured. So the deposit is paid and the bond, if there is one, is in place and it has been granted. So we do this by way of the mortgage originator or a financial institution. Once we know that the purchase price has been secured, we ensure that both buyer and seller consult with us and we sign transfer documents. We then apply to the receiver of revenue for a transfer duty receipt and make payment of that transfer duty. That's a very important process. It also needs to be included in our pack when we do enter the deeds office. So once we've got our rates clearance certificate, we've got our transfer duty receipt, all our documents have been signed, all the legal implications and obligations, both buyer and seller, have been complied with in terms of the agreement, we lodge at the deeds office. How long is the deeds office process? It usually takes 7 to 10 days, and your matter will go through 3 different examiners in that process. So nothing gets missed by the deeds office. And in fact, we have one of the best deeds registry systems in the world. And a lot of Europeans come over here to mirror our systems. So nothing gets past them. And that's why it's very important that you have the right legal team ensuring that they take you through that process. Once the matter is registered at the deeds office, we then do a reconciliation of the finances, and then we provide the buyer with the title deed. Unless there's a bond in place, we then provide that to the financial institution that's placed a bond over that property. That's the process.